we had, the love we shared, this is what we're waiting for.
Hello, I'm Polykarpos Parastatidis, I'm 13 years old, and I will talk to you about origami. A brief breakdown of origami. Origami is the Japanese art of paper folding, and it has been one of the most influential factors in modern day science. From a simple pastime hobby, medical tool, and even a telescope sent to space, origami has been implemented into modern day science many times. But how can such a simple art be so helpful to scientists all across the globe, and what other things has it accomplished? Let's first take a look into the past and see its origins. It's unclear exactly who or when first had the bright idea to fold paper, but what we do know is that it started sometime after Buddhist monks carried the paper to Japan during the 6th century. The first Japanese origami dates from this period, and it was used for religious ceremonial purposes only, due to the high price of paper. The first origami book to have been published is Senchaburo Origata in 1797. It showed diagrams of simple models based on the paper grain, such as the two-leaved grains. There have also been multiple origami-related stories, some lesser known ones like the legend of Abe no Shimei, an ancient Japanese scientist who managed to bring paper grains to life, and some that are well known like the story of Siddhartha and the Thousand Grains. Now, having talked about the origin of origami, I think I should touch on its many different uses. A group of researchers from Arizona State University constructed a 14-fold paper-based lithium-ion battery that was not only space-efficient due to its folding ability, but the battery was even stronger when folded due to aerial energy density. It's folded using the Miura-Ori folding technique, which you may stumble upon when unfolding a map, that allows a square or rectangular piece of paper to be folded in such a way that it can be opened by simply pulling to opposite corners. Origami can also be found naturally. Researchers Kuribayashi and Shigetomi from the University of Tokyo figured something out in December of 2012. When living cells were placed in microplates and are induced to contract, they make the microplates folded to different 3D shapes like cubes, spiral cubes, or dodecahedron. Origami has also made an appearance in the medical field. In 2003, Zhong Yu and Kaori Kuribayashi from the University of Oxford developed an origami stand that, using the waterboard-based style, is used to enlarge clogged arteries and veins. A stand is a tube which can be collapsed into a smaller size. Using a balloon catheter, the stand is maneuvered through the patient's veins / arteries to the clogged site. When the balloon is inflated, the stand is expanded to a larger diameter, thereby opening the veins / artery for better blood flow. Now, as unexpected as it may sound, to origami, the earth is in the limit. In 2014, researchers at Brigham Young University, National Science Foundation, NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, and origami expert Robert Lang designed a space array which can be folded compactly and then deployed while in outer space. This isn't the first time origami has been used in the field of astronomy. But in 2002, professional origami artist Robert Lang helped scientists at the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory design a method for folding a space telescope so that it can be easily deployed when in space. The eyeglass is a telescopic lens that will shrink half its size when folded. This proposed idea was also not went into space, but in 2004, a smaller prototype was made and worked perfectly. Yes, this is very similar to the most recent telescope, but it's actually not the original idea of this concept. In March of 1995, Japanese scientists developed a research vessel called Space Flight Unit. This solar array was folded to a square, and when deployed, would expand to a solar sail. You may be thinking that it also was sent into space, as all of the other telescopes have mentioned, and if so, you're wrong. It was successfully deployed in the same year and unfolded, using the newer Aori style. Another question that may come to mind is, how can you learn to make origami, and in what other ways can someone follow it all? Many people believe that origami is a male skill and can be done by everyone, but that is far from the truth. With a little patience, everyone can make some simple models, and if you continue to practice and practice, you can even make more complex models. All it takes is practice and patience. You can go to any streaming site, search origami, and millions of tutorials will pop up, from simple models that will be finished in 5 minutes to super complex models that will take days or even weeks to make. I personally started at 7 years old with these very easy models, and with many years of practice, I now can make very pretty pieces that can amaze someone at first glance. It's just practice. Let me show you a few. Now, having all that said, one can also follow a diagram or a crease pattern to make a model. What is a diagram, or CP as they are called for short? A diagram is a series of complex drawings that, using a particular set of symbols, teaches someone in what way a fold is made. And a crease pattern is what a finished model looks like if you unfolded the paper. Diagrams are typically followed by little captions that help you understand what the above illustration is trying to show. You often hear phrases like mountain or valley fold in these little captions, which mountain means the fold is outwards and valley the fold is inwards. Makes sense, right? In crease patterns, you will find mountain folds color red and valley folds color blue most of the time. Now it's time for you to fold.
Came from the dreams we had, the love we shared. This is what we're waiting for. And in my mind, in my head, this is where we all came from. The dreams we had, the love we shared.